Dr. Shakeen Singh from Amritsar talking about the legal and statutory compliances. Over to you, Dr. Shakeen. Shakeen sir, you are on mute.
Just a minute. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
So good morning to all, and sorry for the glitches. Basically, my previous system was not working. I had to shift onto the other system. And thank you, Dr. Gagan, for including me in this important IC. So I will talk about the statutories. The legal responsibility of an hospital is being in a public institution, deal with the life and death, hence carries specific responsibilities and liability within and outside the hospital. Failure to comply invite legal actions. I suppose I have to rush far because we are less of the time. Liability of the hospital to the owner to follow the rules and regulation for achieving the objects, to the staff to provide a safe, healthy, congenital atmosphere to the work. Safety of the building and equipment and sanitary environment, contractual obligation to supplier service providers, adequate safety for the patients, relatives, and visitors, breach of legal obligations by any staff, maintenance of law, order, and adequate facilities. The hospital is, carries the responsibilities towards the patients, towards the relatives, the visitors, hospital staff, police, local government and society, women organization, youth organizations. The different regulations which we go across is an instrument mandated by the government to impose self set of conditions which a SEO must comply with before and after it is permitted to operate. These regulations are based on the minimum standards, inspections, enforcement and public accountability. Statutory compliances are statutory means of or related to statutes or what we normally call law or regulations. Compliance just means to comply with all adherence to these. So statutory compliance means so you are following the law on a given issue. Statutory regulations ensure that the providers adhere to at least the basic minimum standards. High quality of service, however, calls for more than just a statutory obligations. Law can be best force the hospital to follow the standards in a letter, but not in the spirit. It shows that the provider adhere to at least the basic minimum standards, more than just the statutory obligations. It's more than, but not more quality. The spirit is more important than the letter. Healthcare laws, three main sources: statutes, case law, code of conduct. Statutes, regulations, statutory instruments, requirements that must be adhered to. Specific for medical field only, many others not specific to medicines. Case law. Case law principles derives from the interpretation of individual court cases, for example, consent, confidentiality, and medical negligence. This applies to all areas of clinical practice and represents a constantly evolving area of law which changes the way we deliver medical services, what we can call a common law. Code of conduct and ethic issued by the medical councils, like your registration. Law relevant for hospitals, registration and licensing, during commissioning, during functioning, and common act. Registration and licensing requirements towards shop and establishment act, licensing for blood bank, building permit, NOC for chief fire officer, from chief fire officer, licensing for NOC under pollution control, license to operate lift under left escalate, etc. NOC for DG set if it's there. Common acts also applicable to healthcare are like Employment Provident Fund and Miscellaneous Provision Act and the Income Tax Act, related law, sexual abuse law, laws act specifically for healthcare institutions like PCP and DT, Drug and Cosmetic Act 1945, license under narcotics and psychotropic substances, biomedical waste, transplant, HOTA, Food Safety and Standard Act 2006, Motor Vehicle Act if you have an ambulance, relevant public health legislation like Epidemic Act, like nowadays the COVID-19, HIV AIDS bills, registration for birth, death, notifiable disease, Environment Protection Act. Statutory documentations towards clinical documentation, towards medical legal records, income tax record, pharmacy records, employee records, banking record, reportable and notifiable disease record, building and special norms. The regulations related to building permission, norm and space allocations are statutory obligations. Ensure adequate space, lightning, ventilation, continuous potable water and power supply under National Building Code. Building and special norms, allotment of a land approved for use of a hospital purpose is required under the Urban Act, Land Act. Planning, building the hospital is controlled by the local municipal law. Building plan have to be approved by the local government. No objection certificate from the fire departments, a certificate from the electricity department, a certificate of fitness for the operating the lift. Starting managing a SU, a proprietorship or a private partnership, a working hours, composition of the employee, etc. under the Shop and Establishment Act. Safe, hazard-free environment. Safe and hazard-free environment, do not no harm is the basic mandate. The law make it obligatory safety of all stakeholders, like fire NOC, PCB, and biomedical waste. Safety ensures with accreditations. Verify the plan of the organization has a plan and provision for early detection, abatement, containment of the fire and a non-fire emergency. This is the most commonly seen across our emergencies. The organization has a documented safe exit plan in case of fire and non-fire emergencies. Staff is trained for their role in case of such an emergency, for which we need to have a mock drill kind of things. Conduct and documents and nurses and HR. IMC Professional Conduct Ethics Regulation 2002 Code of Ethics has both moral authorities and legal bindings. Any serious violations renders the individual liable to cancellation of the registration and a penal action under the law of tort, negligence, or even IPC. Maintenance of the medical record. Every medical record has a unique identifier. Organization has a policy identifies those authorized to make entry into the medical record. Every medical record entry is dated and timed. The author of the entry can be identified. The content of the medical record are identified and documented. The record providers and up to date the chronological account. This is the most commonly seen, NCs during inspections. Display of a registration number is a mandatory issue. IMC regulation towards advertisement is there certain guidelines. We should not be unnecessarily advertising. You have to share certain information that should be within a rule regulations. Then the membership in a medical society, you need to be registered within a state where you're practicing. Towards the biomedical waste is a big issue nowadays. Right of the patients, consent, employees expressed and qualified. Under RDI, it's obligatory for the service provider to provide all the information required to the patients on demand about his treatment. SCO required to display the registration certificates and the service along with the residual of a changes. Quality management of full information of and education discussion about the course, open and the risk benefits and the initiation and the treatment or even the alternative for that. Security of the patients. Security of the patient while in a hospital, especially vulnerable group is more important, like women, infants, children, old and unconscious patients. Prime responsibility of the hospital and the treating doctor, hospital proprietor, administrator, they are accountable and punishable under this act. Safe medication, the Drug and Cosmetic Act, Pharmacy Act, and NDPS Act provides for safe storage, preservation, prescription, dispensing of drug by qualified and authorized person only. HR management is another different important aspect is the statutory compliance for HR is the ESI, Provident Fund, Profession Tax, Gratuity, the Minimum Wages Act, the Maternity Benefit Act, the Payment of the Bonus Act, the Payment of the Wages Act. Hospital employee rule and regulations, patient life and safety comes first. Essential service defined under Essential Service Maintenance Act. Other regulations governing the business aspects is the Income Tax, Income Tax Act 1961, Sale Tax, Water Registration, Certification, Vehicle Registration. Other statutory required commonly overlooked by the SCOs are to practice medicine without proper registration with the state medical council or the medical council of India would violate express, because somebody is registered maybe in Maharashtra or a central is practicing in Punjab, or person registered in Punjab cannot practice in Rajasthan or somewhere else. So also this is for employee staff that is unqualified will violate the provision of the Indian Medical Act Council. Emergency treatment, no healthcare provider or healthcare establishment shall refuse a person emergency medical treatment until such person stabilizes irrespective of the person's capacity to pay. If a facility for the requirement emergency medical treatment is not available with the healthcare establishment, it shall be the duty of the SEO to provide him the first aid and make him the appropriate arrangement to shift him to the nearby SEO. Non-discrimination in the healthcare. We cannot discriminate the patient on the basis of the age, sex, class, place of residence, religion, caste, physical or mental ability, mental health stature, or HIV status, whatsoever. Treatment in medical legal cases, when any issues of a healthcare establishment is involved in a case that is of a medical legal nature, no healthcare provider or healthcare establishment shall deny treatment merely on the ground of receiving police clearance before starting the treatment. Sorry, I'm stuck with my slide.
Your slides are moving, Shakin.
Yeah. Okay. Then towards the confidentiality, all information concerning a user's, including information relating to, am I audible? His or her health status.
Yes.
Treatment or a stay in the healthcare establishment or in, is a confidential and is to be treated as such. No person may disclose any information, including any record of the users contemplating in a subsection unless the user consent to that disclosure in writing. A court order or any law requires such disclosure, or a non-disclosure of the information represents a serious threat to the public health. Maintenance of the confidentiality shall be taken with respect to a person affected by HIV, AIDS, etc. A person with a mental health problem too. Second opinion. On requesting for a second opinion or an opinion on his or her health status from another healthcare provider, the user shall not be prevented from consulting. The assess maintenance of the record. The person in charge of a healthcare establishment shall ensure that a health record contains such relevant information as may be prescribed is created and maintained at that healthcare establishment for every user of the health services. The patient shall have a complete access to all of his health record and shall have the right to be provided with a report of the diagnosis, the medical treatment, the state of his or her medical conditions and the investigation whatsoever. Overview of the national health legislations, present status, 10 core areas, important law applicable to private practice, Indian Medical Code, biomedical management, human resources. Recent challenges, Clinical Establishment Act, Income Tax, TDS, Service Tax, Insurance, TPA issues. Way forward would be accreditation with the NBH, which is going to help us in the maintenance of all those records and the statutory obligations. Thanks for your patient hearing. Sorry for the glitches in between because of the internet problem.